Hello, I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. In this video, we're going to cover different radon system valves and dampers. And the reason that we use these is it allows us to balance your radon mitigation system. They're especially helpful when you're not using an EC fan that has a potentiometer inside of it that allows us to dial in that radon fan to exactly what we need with the ease of just using a screwdriver. This controls the speed of the fan, so it dials it up or down. But if you don't have that, say you have a conventional fan like this Radonaway RP145, you can use something as simple as a damper or a gate valve like this to be able to kind of dial everything in. It's really helpful when you have multiple suction points where you need to just suck a little bit of air from one spot and maybe more air from another. An example would be a crawl space. Typically, we only need to pull 5 or 10 CFM from a crawl space. So we'll usually use 2-inch PVC with a 2-inch ball valve, and we can kind of dial everything right in, and then it allows us to have the rest of the fan kind of work on, you know, say the drain tile or the subslab depressurization version of that system. So with this setup, I've just got a couple of T's here. I've got a 4-inch gate valve, which is just like this 3-inch gate valve, except bigger. So you can see as I close this handle, it'll close this valve. So when I have this RP145 wide open, which we'll do here, I'll plug this in, it'll consume about 65 watts. So I'm using my watt meter here. And if I remember correctly, at 11 cents a kilowatt, it's about $1 a watt to operate the fan. So if this is around 64 watts, it's gonna cost about $64 per year just to power the fan. Now that does not take into account the conditioned air loss, which is the greatest operating cost, and it's the hardest one to figure. We got a video that shows how we calculate the operating cost using a spreadsheet, thanks to Chad Robinson. But you can check out that card there for that video. So here, 64 watts, you'll see as I start to close this valve, we're gonna see the static pressure on the U-tube go up. We're at 0.2 inches right now. So I'll close it about halfway. We're up to around 1 inch of static pressure, and we drop to about 50 watts. Now I'll close that a little bit more, and it's almost all the way closed, and we're at 1.9 inches of static pressure and 34 watts. So this allows us to kind of dial everything in. And the reason we'd want to dial something in like this, you might look at that and say, big deal, you saved 30 watts, so you saved $30 just to power the radon fan. But remember that conditioned air loss is usually the largest component of the radon system operating cost. And what I mean by that is, say you've got block tops on a house with drain tile that aren't sealed, or it's a finished basement, you can't get at it to seal it. Say that system's moving 80 CFM, well, half of that air or more might be coming from your home. And if you're pulling 40 CFM from the house, you know, there's an energy penalty to that. And it can be substantial at times. We've seen some systems that when you figure in the operating cost or figure in the conditioned air to the operating cost, they're north of $1,000 a year to operate. And that's a pretty big number. So when you can dial it in with a damper or the EC fan, that really helps not only the power consumption of the fan, but the conditioned air loss, which again is the big one. So here we've got that dialed down. I'll close it all the way. And wattage stays about the same, and it just creeps up to 2 inches. So the downside to these valves, these gate valves, is when you have it almost all the way closed, you get a whistle. And this valve is in the house, so Like that would drive me crazy if it was in my bedroom closet or something like that. And that valve is open probably about that far right now, somewhere in that range. So it's fine if it's open like that, but if it's just cracked like that, you're not gonna wanna use a gate valve. So we'll shut that off. We'll use a valve like this. So we'll put a link to these in the description. But it's just got a wing nut on here. So you take that wing nut off, and then it's got a handle, and then the washer. Leave the washer on. You drill a 5/16 hole inside the pipe. I believe it's 5/16, double check. And then you take and push this down, slide it in the hole, and then you'll release it. And then normally I'll put a dab of silicone on there so that it gets a seal. And you put the handle back on and then the wing nut. And then your pipe would be something like this. It does not seal all the way, but it is close enough in most cases. And then you've got some adjustment there so you can adjust that valve. Remember to mark the setting and tighten it down so nobody hits it on accident and moves it. And one last thing. The whole reason we started using valves in the first place is because when we started doing pressure field extension, we quickly realized there were many instances where, say, the RP145 or the Maverick or the RN2 was oversized for the house that we were working on. Say we were looking for 3 pascals of negative pressure in our weakest test hole, and say this delivered 5. We would then switch to the smaller fan, say the RP140 or the Spirit or the RN1, and there was many instances where that was too small. It was like, do we put in the small one and not get the radon reduction we want, or do we put in the big one and now we're going to have the energy penalty of it being oversized and it's costing the customer maybe a couple extra $100 a year to operate when we figured in that conditioned air loss. The valve or the damper allowed us to make the fan that was too big kind of come down and be that in between the small fan and the medium sized fan. And that's really why we started using the valves and dampers. And I would encourage you to give it a try. All right, I'm Jesse with American Radon. Thank you so much for watching.